So opening up this route here, this is our aggregation for analytics and reporting route. And here we see we've got several different data feeds, some HL7, some EDI, some FHIR JSON, but we'll be primarily dealing with our EDI feed. And so how this is assembled is we have our source systems on the left, so you can think of each row as a place we're getting data from. We have our target systems on the right. This is every place we're sending data to. And then no matter which system it comes from or the data format, it moves through the same assembly line process as it's ingested, transformed, routed, and finally sent to its final destination. So really quickly, this is our data mapper here. This is our three-pane graphical drag-and-drop mapping tool. So how this is assembled is we have our source format on the left. So this is our, since we're dealing with EDI, we've got our EDI 837 XML here. You can see all of our loops there. And then on our target side, we've got this little pination canonical XML structure that we're hoping to produce. And so you basically drag and drop into this center pane to build your mapping, and with the tools palette at the top for more complex operations as needed. And so it's really just as simple as looking here. So we've got our patient last name here, and we've just navigated through the tree to get our 2000B, 2000BA, get our NM103, drag it into the pane, and then it's ready to go. So let's go ahead and look at it in testing mode. So we'll look at some real data flowing through. So here we'll load up this EDI test that I have saved. And as I hit go, we'll see the data move through the system, moving left to right through the stages. And so it's really just that simple with the EI console. As you can see, in just a few easy steps, we were able to ingest some data, transform it to XML, and then transform it into both database statements and then also into some JSON, a different file format, and then send them both on to their final destination systems.